Spain, with its promise of sun-soaked beaches, vibrant culture, and relaxed pace of life, has long been a siren call for many. The allure of trading in gray skies for endless blue, of swapping hectic schedules for long, leisurely meals, is undeniable. As a Dutchman, I too was captivated by the promise of a life less ordinary. Little did I know, Spain had a whole repertoire of surprises waiting for me, a delightful dance of cultural quirks that would turn my well-ordered world upside down. The initial euphoria of arriving in this sun-drenched land was intoxicating. The warmth of the people, the beauty of the language, the charm of the cobblestone streets, it was like stepping into a postcard. But as the initial excitement subsided, I began to realize that life in Spain was a different tempo altogether. It was a rhythm I had yet to learn, a melody with unexpected notes. This is the story of my journey, a Dutch expat's initiation into the heart of Spain. If you enjoyed this glimpse into my adventure, please subscribe and follow Urban Trends. Watch for more fascinating stories and insights. In the Netherlands, time is a precious commodity, measured out in precise, efficient blocks. Punctuality is not just polite, it's an article of faith. But in Spain, time takes on a more fluid quality, stretching and contracting like the afternoon siesta. Spanish time is a real phenomenon, a concept that baffled this punctual Dutchman at first. Arriving at a restaurant at the appointed hour, I'd find myself alone, the restaurant deserted. Friends would arrive, not with apologies, but with a shrug and a smile. "Tranquilo," they'd say, "we're on Spanish time." Slowly, I began to understand. In Spain, it's not about adhering to the clock, but about savoring the moment, lingering over conversations, and enjoying the company of friends and family. One of the most significant adjustments for this time-conscious Dutchman was the siesta. In the Netherlands, the workday powers through, fueled by coffee and a commitment to efficiency. But in Spain, the siesta reigns supreme, a sacred midday break that throws a wrench into the gears of productivity. At first, I fought against the siren call of the siesta. I'd sit at my desk, determined to power through the afternoon slump. But the Spanish sun, the lure of a delicious lunch, and the sight of shops shuttered for the afternoon proved too strong to resist. I surrendered to the siesta, and in its embrace, I discovered a secret. The siesta wasn't about laziness, it was about rejuvenation, a chance to recharge and return to work refreshed and energized. The Dutch, known for their directness, can sometimes come across as reserved. Physical contact is limited, personal space is sacred. In Spain, however, warmth and expressiveness reign supreme. Greetings involve kisses on both cheeks, conversations are peppered with animated gestures, and physical touch is a natural part of communication. I'll never forget the first time a Spanish friend greeted me with a hearty hug and a kiss on each cheek. I stood there, stiff as a board, my Dutch reserve on full display. But the warmth of the Spanish embrace soon melted away my awkwardness. I learned to embrace the physicality of Spanish culture, to express myself with my hands, and to greet friends with a warmth that felt both foreign and exhilarating. Section 5. A fiesta of flavors, tapas, and long meals. Food in Spain is not just sustenance, it's a celebration of life, a sensory fiesta that tantalizes the taste buds. Gone are the days of Dutch efficiency, of sandwiches gobbled down at desks. In Spain, meals are long, leisurely affairs, opportunities to connect with loved ones and savor each delicious bite. The concept of tapas, small plates designed for sharing, was a revelation. It wasn't just about the food, but about the communal experience. The joy of trying a bit of everything and sharing laughter and conversation over plates piled high with culinary delights. In Spain, I discovered a passion for food, a love of lingering over meals that stretched late into the evening. Section 6. Sun-drenched days and lively nights. The Netherlands, with its gray skies and unpredictable weather, can feel a world away from the sun-drenched shores of Spain. In Spain, the sun is a constant companion, a source of warmth and vitality that permeates every aspect of life. Outdoor living is the norm, and life spills out onto the streets, filling plazas with laughter and the aroma of freshly brewed coffee. The Spanish rhythm of life, so different from the Dutch penchant for early evenings, took some getting used to. Dinner at 10 p.m.? Why not? A stroll through the streets at midnight, perfectly normal. I learned to embrace the late-night energy of Spain, the way the day seamlessly transitioned into night, filled with laughter, music, and the clinking of glasses. Section 7. Work to live, live to work. In the Netherlands, there's a strong work ethic, a sense of duty that often translates into long hours and a focus on achievement. In Spain, the approach to work-life balance is refreshingly different. Work is important, but it's not the be-all and end-all. Family, friends, and personal time are given equal weight, creating a more balanced and fulfilling lifestyle. The concept of taking a long lunch break to go home for a leisurely meal with family was foreign to me. But as I witnessed the Spanish commitment to savoring life's simple pleasures, I began to question my own priorities. I learned to prioritize time with loved ones, to leave work at the office, and to embrace the Spanish philosophy of work to live, not live to work. Section 8. Finding the rhythm of Spain. Living in Spain has been a journey of discovery, a crash course in embracing the unexpected. From the fluid concept of time to the warmth of the people, from the siesta to the tapas culture, Spain has challenged my preconceived notions and opened my eyes to a different way of life. It hasn't always been easy. There have been moments of frustration, of cultural misunderstandings, of longing for the familiar comforts of home. But with each passing day, I find myself falling more in love with the Spanish way of life. I'm learning to let go of the need for control, to embrace spontaneity, and to savor the moment. Section 9. Embrace the unexpected. As I navigate the labyrinthine streets of my adopted city, I'm struck by the realization that the very things that initially shocked me have become the things I cherish most. The cultural quirks, the unexpected encounters, the moments that make me pause and smile. These are the threads that weave together the rich tapestry of life in Spain. Spain has taught me that life is not meant to be rushed. It's about slowing down, savoring each moment, and embracing the unexpected. It's about finding joy in the simple things, connecting with loved ones, and living life to the fullest. And as I raise a glass of Rioja to the setting sun, I can't help but feel a sense of gratitude for this unexpected journey, for the opportunity to experience life through a different lens, to embrace the beauty of cultural diversity, and to find my own rhythm in the heart of Spain.